1956, a publication house called Présence Africaine organized the Black Writers and Artists Congress at the Sorbonne in Paris. And the idea for behind this Congress was basically to talk about Black culture. Is such a thing as Black culture? What is it? Is it something that's unchanging, that you can find everywhere? You have the Black diaspora from Africa to Europe to the United States. Do all Black people have the same culture? Or is it a changing culture from place to place? And at that point in the Congress, in the Paris Congress, people like Fanon and Césaire say, well, the most fruitful thing for us, therefore, is to look at this oppression and to begin to talk about decolonization. And as we decolonize ourselves, we create our new cultures. And this is why Césaire said, and Fanon said it also, that il n'y a de culture nationale. There is only national culture is culture because the nation protects the culture. Look at what happened after 56, this conference. Because in many ways, Senghor plans, position was to use negritude for, to use this conference as a platform for launching negritude as a universal Black movement. But in what happened instead was the challenge of negritude by even Césaire, who was a founding father of negritude, when he began to talk about nationalism. Challenge of negritude certainly by Fanon, and challenge of negritude by the Black American who said, we American, we Westerners, we not African. But the key point for me here is that the debate for nation building actually replaced negritude already in the 60s. Many countries said, we are Nigerians, we are Ghanaians, we are Congolese, as opposed to being Black. So negritude was challenged like that. But Senghor went on and began to apply negritude in the education of Senegal, in creating museums. For example, he did the very first exposition, a show of Picasso, of Chagall, of Soulages, and people like that, but also create all kind of museums and art schools, Beaux-Arts school, and so on. So that what happened in the particular case of Africa is that they began to have competing ideas of what is Black. You know, so particularly two countries are interesting in this. Could be more than two countries. One could talk about Nigeria and Ghana, but I just stay in Francophone Africa. If you look at Guinea versus Senegal, Guinea has the cultural nationalism, a cultural revolution, and they're using Fanon's thesis of nation state, and then they basically are putting themselves on a developmental track. They're saying we need to catch up with the West, we need to send people to school, we need to have modern ballets, we need to have modern theater. So we need basically a Marxist form of westernization or progress in Africa. This is the Guinean model. And then the Senegalese model will be the negritude model that we talked about. If you look at fine art, I think the negritude model persisted, stayed alive, because Senghor had created school. The students coming out of that school either were reacting to negritude or reaffirming negritude. In either case, they were working with negritude in many ways. And because also they had the biennales in Senegal, because they had art schools there, because they have these big shows there of Soulages, of Picasso, Chagall, and so on, Senegalese become primarily more sophisticated in fine art than the other African countries.
See, I mean, the Nigerian, through Wole Soyinka and many people, were critical of negritude, but actually negritude reappears in the Nigerian art than any other place. You know, their relation to the spirits, their the ancestors, their relation to rhythm, African colors, the whole, you know, pantheon of gods. Everywhere Senghor was defining negritude has become the Yoruba art, in many ways, the Yoruba culture. So Soyinka is beginning more and more to acknowledge this. Today, clearly, there is a return, at least by many of us, several colleagues, myself included, to a reassessment of those moments. And Senghor is no longer a villain. What is interesting that the legacy of the conference of Senghor is that he was one of the central thinkers of blacks in modernity. If you just look at the black experience in modernity, who has a program? Senghor had a program. I'm not talking about, is he right, is he wrong? He had a program that was a modernist program. The same way you see the surrealist, the same way you see the expressionist, Senghor had a plan. Fanon had a plan. His plans fail, and I think the problem is we took Fanon's plan and applied it literally to countries. Senghor took his plan too, but so if you look at the repercussions in art, ultimately Senghor is winning.